10-year anniversary show. I'm very excited and pleased to present the person you have all been waiting for the next 90 minutes, Mr. Will Wheaton.
Non-commercial share-alike license. So please feel free to videotape and share and mash up and do awesome things with this if you can. Just please apply that license to it and then let me know that you did something so I can see it. The second thing is that for those of you with children or for those of you who are especially sensitive to naughty words, I do my very best to keep this clean, but the reality is I go somewhere between PG-13 and R. I lean a bit toward R. Damn it, Paul. Paul Saborn is texting me asking penises because he knows that my phone is talking. Oh, if you could someday have friends who text you asking penises while you're trying to perform in front of 3,000 people, then you will know that you are truly a lucky and rich human being. So, those are the important notes. Now, what I want to do today is find my water. Is there somebody from the con who wants some water? This is what I'm doing today. I have been very busy for the last few months, and I want to tell you about two of the things that I've been doing that have kept me busy, and then I'm going to tell you stories. The very first thing that I've been doing that has kept me busy since last summer is creating, producing, working on, and editing a program for Felicia Day's Geek and Sundry YouTube channel called Tabletop. Show. I feel like the entire room down in the, like, we call it the celebrity ghetto, where we're like signing autographs and stuff. So these two guys come out, and there are a couple of tables down from me. These two guys come out, and every teenage girl and their mom in the room screams like the Beatles have come out. And I'm like, holy crap, the Beatles are here. Those aren't the Beatles. Those aren't even the Monkees. Who are these guys? So it turns out that they're the twins from Harry Potter. I'm as excited for Tabletop as everyone else is for that. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about a year ago, Felicia Day called me and she asked me if I would be interested in working on a show together. And everything that we have done together has been amazing and fun. And I said, yes, of course, we'll do something together. And she said, I'm starting this YouTube channel. And they're giving me a little bit of a budget to produce shows. And I would like to do a show with you. What do you think about doing a show where you review board games and video games and things like that? And I said, that sounds very interesting. How about a show where, oh my God, we play tabletop games, board games, card games, and RPGs. And my brain's like, oh, look at all these ideas. This is the thing you've been wanting to do for your entire life. And we invite our interesting friends, writers, artists, creators, actors, YouTubers, to come over and play these games with us. And then we're sort of reviewing the games because we're showing by example how awesome the gaming hobby is. And then we're also letting people who are big fans of people like Grant Imahara and Ryan Higa and Jane Espenson see what they're like. Thank you. What they're, if you were standing where I am, it's very hard to see the tiny little hole where the water lives. I'm just going to not comment on that for a minute. I'm not going to tell you what I have now named this little hole. But some of you can probably figure it out. So I said, oh, this would be so great, so we'll do this show. And she said, that sounds great. And for the next couple of months, we developed the show. We took what I loved about Celebrity Poker Showdown and what I loved about Jon Favreau's program, Dinner for Five, and we put them together, and we replaced the game of No Limit Texas Hold'em with games like Settlers of Catan, and Fiasco, and Ticket to Ride, and Alhambra, and The Last Night on Earth, and Pandemic, and Munchkin, and we put together, we shot 20 episodes in 10 days, and I know you should be impressed because it was really freaking hard to do. And the first episode of Tabletop premieres Monday, April 2nd. I know, I'm so excited! At youtube.com/geekandsundry. And if you want to know all about the show, you can go to tabletop.geekandsundry.com and you can watch a little video there of what the show looks like. I brought the DVD of the reel, and then of course I left it in my suitcase. Because I'm smart like that. I plan ahead, and then I forget important things. I did remember the key before I came up here. So, I know, thank you, I'm kind of proud of myself as well. So I worked on Tabletop for a very long time, it was incredibly awesome and super, super fun. And I finished editing and locking everything right before we announced the show at WonderCon. I was working up until the day that we announced the show. So I'm real excited. And new episodes are going to premiere every other Friday. We share the sort of time slot with Veronica Belmont and her show Sword and Laser. And on the off weeks, we're going to have outtakes and behind-the-scenes shoots and maybe some interviews with game developers. I'm going to do some live chats talking about games. It's going to be really exciting. So I'm really looking forward to that, and it's going to be great. So that is one of the things that's been taking up a great deal of my time. The other thing that came about very unexpectedly right before I came to be in Seattle is another episode of The Big Bang Theory. Eagle Will Wheatley returns in about another 2 or 3 weeks. I don't know exactly how the schedule is. Some of the funniest moments I've seen on the show are in this particular episode. That's all I'm going to tell you about it. One of the things that I will tell you is that I spent, after the most recent episode, Big Bang Theory, Sheldon and Eagle Will Wheaton are now ostensibly friends. So there is a scene where we're sitting next to each other in a restaurant. And you're not going to put it in the hole, right? So, I did spend an entire day sitting next to Jim Parsons, and that was as awesome as you think it would be. I have also concluded that Johnny Galecki is the most effortlessly handsome man on the planet Earth. One day he comes in and like sweats in a torn up t-shirt and just manages to look sort of like rugged and sexy. The very next day he comes in like a tie and the shoes, and he's all put together, and Simon Helberg and I were like, why does he do this? It's rehearsal, no one cares. But he looks like he stepped off the cover of Italian Vogue. So that episode premieres in just a couple of weeks.